What's up, guys? Broken Oaks here for another video, playing some King's Raid. And in this video, I'll be showing you guys my Nalia Soloing Red Dragon 55, and I'll give you a little baby guide on her. So right here, you can see her basic stats and her additional stats. You can see the attack speed, the lifesteal, accuracy, crit chance, and her bonus attack percentages. And right here is her equipment substats. And of course, you can see the stars right there, and you can see the runes. And you can see her Flame Shield of Death got that 5-star, her Blood Earrings 5-star, and of course her Orb is 5-stars. And those are really crucial when you're soloing Dragon. And of course, Transcendent, she got the first, she went through the first pathway, which is a 30% attack bonus when you're in battle. So of course, you won't see it being affected. Well, actually, you won't see it affecting her stats, just her individual stats, only when she's in-game. You can see the little box coming up real soon. All right, so when you building Nalia, and like for all characters, you need like a decent amount of accuracy. I would recommend at least 25% accuracy. I don't think 10% is good enough, but I alter her a little bit so that she can solo 55 with a higher percent chance. But especially with Nalia, like her passive and her stuns are extremely crucial, and also that's just the way how she is built. That's her kit. She's a CC monster. She does crazy CC, and also with her 3, she gets bonus damage if the enemy is knocked down. Even though it is a really expensive combo, since it requires 5 mana to get it off. But you know, I have a Philip, so I can actually combo with his 3 mana attack. Then I can use my dive bomb to get that bonus attack. But the way I built Nalia, you can see it's not really, let's see, at least in the arena meta, it's not how you're supposed to build her. Because people, they use her as a frontline tank. And for the first path of Transcendent, they would actually use the 30% HP bonus. But since I have Philip, I got Philip out of the inn for free long before I got Nalia out the inn for free. So I'm like, alright, so I don't really need to focus too much on a frontline tank for her. And that is why I went for the damaging pathway instead of the more meta, sturdy, tanky pathway, which is the 30% HP. So besides accuracy, other important stats you want to have on her is lifesteal. With all these frontliners like warriors and knights, it's really effective for them because when you're taking damage, you also want to at least recover that damage that you're receiving so that your tank or your warrior can actually stay alive in battle a lot longer and dish out more damage, CC, etc., or debuffs. So that's why lifesteal is so important. It's even being demonstrated in this video while she's soloing 55 on how important it is
to have lifesteal on Nalia. Also, when you're building Nalia, at least how I build all my warriors, is that you want them to be a bruiser. A bruiser is a character that dishes out a good amount of damage and also can receive a decent amount of damage. Unlike a DPS like Rodina or Pavel, they will just get blown up once the enemy starts focusing on them. But it's not the case with a warrior or a knight, because they can withstand a lot more defense. Well, they can withstand a lot more damage because of their base stats.
So that's why with Nalia, you can see that she has like around 5k, I think a little bit above 5k of physical and magic defense. And it's being demonstrated in this video how useful that is. Because of that, she can withstand the damage from this dragon, and she can also just recover her HP off of her lifesteal. So that's why you need to have those to synergize well together with the attack, because the attack is the source of how much HP is actually being recovered, about 30%. And you know, when I crit, I will also get, you know, 30% of whatever I crit as HP. But the way she's built currently, I'm gonna be overhauling a lot once I get her unique weapon. If I'm correct, on the 100 day event, you think you get a free unique weapon. Plus, I'm like really close to getting like 30k, what is it, arena points. I'm at like 20k currently, so I'm gonna get her unique weapon real soon. So I need to edit her a little bit. But besides that, as just a quick summary, accuracy needs to be around like 25%. You want to get at least a decent amount of lifesteal. Maybe not 30%. You might get a little less than that. Her damage needs to be adequate enough, and she needs to be sturdy enough to actually be able to withstand damage so that it will be useful all around in every scenario. But besides that, hope you guys have a great day, great night, all that good stuff. I'll be throwing up some more tips and guides in the near future, and I'll talk to you guys later. Peace out.